let's have a look at the process paths that the tool generated for us. Here's our timelines view. Each of these horizontal lines represents a separate instance of the process, in this case, a separate claim. The icons show up here as the different events that have occurred along the processing of any one of our different claims. The length of the timelines themselves are proportionate to the elapsed time. So when you scroll this, you can see some are going to span farther than others. They took longer. You've got empty spaces in certain places where essentially nothing is occurring. You're sitting and waiting for that claim to be processed. No event has happened in between these two stages. Now, if I click any one of these, I get very detailed information on the single instance of the process, the single claim. So I've got claim or timeline number X here. This could be any claim in my data set. I've got all 30,000 plus here available to me right now. And you can see I've got all of my interrelated steps that occurred. And so we'll start with the superset of all the steps. We can see when first notification of loss occurred and then went on to coverage confirmation. I've got all of my time gaps as to when that happened, and keep in mind, this is a single instance of the process. I've also got that attribute related data here as well. So who was associated with this claim? Where did it come from? What type was it? And so on. Now, as I scroll down here, you see in sequence all the different events that have been pieced together. We went through kind of a simple example where we loaded across only one data set. If we had a more real-world scenario where we loaded from multiple different data sources, this is going to reflect all the different events that occurred across all those disparate systems and piece it together to give you that composite life view of the process instance of the claim, regardless of the system of record that would be responsible for any one portion of this process. So this is going to full end-to-end lifecycle, and you've got this for each and every claim in the dataset. And you can page through them if you'd like. The thing to point out here is subprocesses. You notice I checked that checkbox. Right now we're running statistical analysis, so this is based on stats. But what we've done is, we've picked out these events that are most commonly done together or as mutually exclusive events, and you can see them color-coded and grouped out here via the lines. So in this insurance example use case, you might expect that every claim should have a first notification of loss, a coverage confirmation, and probably an adjuster on it. But not every vehicle claim would have an injury claim submitted as part of that, or maybe a rental car issue, or a total loss with corresponding salvage information. And so you see these things automatically broken out here and grouped together as the sub or parallel processes of this overall workflow. Again, automatically done by statistical analysis. If you have some kind of an identifier in your dataset which signifies maybe like a task level ID where all these items should be grouped together by this task ID, we can define that here. You would just base it on your attribute field. You point to your task ID field and all the interrelated events that took place as part of that task would be grouped together in that way. But in this way, the system does it automatically for us. So this is a single instance of the process, a single timeline.